Okay, good evening friends. Today we will discuss on another important floriculture crop, China aster. I hope my voice is clear and the screen is visible for everyone. Yes, okay. If it is the case, then I will continue the class now. We will discuss on the China aster now. China aster.
The recording has stopped.
Yes, okay. Audible na? Something said. Yes, is this clear? Can I continue?
It's audible.
Yeah, okay.
Yes, sir, audible.
Okay, sure. I will continue now. Today we will discuss on China aster. China aster, botanical name is? Calistiphus chinensis, belongs to family Asteraceae, native to China. Hence the name China aster. Usually in India we call aster, but in other countries the China aster is most popular. And in India also nowadays the trend has been going against the China. Hence the we'll avoid the calling of China aster, we'll call the aster nowadays. Then coming to its history, this is mainly belongs to China and it is introduced by Europeans to other countries. Especially for India also, the Europeans introduced this crop to India. Here the flowers are solitary, solitary means single. Then here we can find three types of variants. Single type, here the very few number of florets or rare florets are observed. Then semi-double, then double type. These are the three predominant flower variants. Then apart from that, traditionally we grow for the loose crop, loose flowers, then cut flowers, and for the landscape purpose and flower decoration and making of garlands. Then coming to history, the China aster breeding was, this is with respect to breeding, mainly originated in France. Then the doubleness, this China aster doubleness, this breeding aspect has been mainly originated in England. We'll skip this. Another important aspect, the importance of this this China aster. This China aster can be utilized as a loose flower, cut flower, then potted plant, then for the landscaping purpose, then for the border purpose, then for the commercial use. Then coming to area and production. This genus Calistiphus is derived from the two Greek word. You kindly remember this one, note down in separately. This word is derived from Greek word. Calistos means most beautiful and Stiphos means a crown, referring to the flower head. This is derived from Greek word. You remember this one. Then China aster is one of the most important garden plant grown throughout the world. It is a commercial flower crop in Russia, Japan, North America, Switzerland, Europe. In India also it is one of the important loose flower. Then apart from that, it ranks third next to the chrysanthemum and marigold among the loose flower. In loose flower, the China aster, marigold and the chrysanthemum, these are the prominent flowers. In India, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, Maharashtra, these are the leading states. Then coming to flower biology, this is also important concept. Here in the flowers we will observe the gytinogamous type of inflorescence or flower. Here the stigma of the individual flower unfolds after the pollen discharged from the flower. Hence it promotes the, what will promote? mainly in this, you kindly remember this one. Jitinogamous condition is mainly observed in China aster. This is the specific botanical name or the type of pollination observed in the China aster flower crop. Then generally the China aster is self-pollinated crop. If they ask in the competitive exams, it is a self-pollinated crop. Only less than 10% is outcrossed. This is a complete self-pollinated crop. This is only exception in the Asteraceae flower. You kindly remember this one. Then coming to the plant characters. Here in the plant type, we can observe the erect type, semi-erect type means branched one, and the spreading type. And with respect to the flowering habit, sparsely flowered, medium dense flower, and densely flowered. These are used for the cut flowers and other for the loose flower production. Then coming to the ray floret shape. Here you observe the ray florets. These are all narrow type and these are all broad type. Here this is the female part of the China aster. This is the petal and this is the female part of China aster flower. The ray florets are, what we call the ray florets in China aster? What their condition? Whether they are hermaphrodites, pistillate, which type?
Pistillate.
Yeah. Then coming to ray florets. After the ray florets, disc florets are hermaphrodite in nature. You observe, these are all the ray florets. They are pistillate in nature. With respect to this disc florets, this yellow portion, these are all in hermaphrodite condition. Both male and female sex organs are present here in the disc florets. But in the outer ray florets, only female part will be present. Then some of the important varieties released from the IHR, like Kamini, Purnima, Shashank.
All matlab Asteraceae family flower jo ray floret wo all are pistillate hota hai.
Yes, generally the ray florets are pistillate in nature in the Asteraceae flower. And the general thumb rule also applied for the disc florets. These are also hermaphrodite in nature. But in case of Gerbera, here in the Gerbera, assume that this is a Gerbera crop, it's also Asteraceae, but the ray florets will be pistillate, disc florets will be hermaphrodite. Both conditions are same, but the transversal florets will also be there, like small petals. This circle will consist of male part of flowers. The pollens will be present in this region in the Gerbera crop. This is the exception in Gerbera. Transversal pollens are present in Gerbera. You remember that one. Then IHR released variety, China aster released one. This is Arka Kamini, then Arka Purnima, then Arka Shashank, Violet Cushion, Arka Adya, Arka Archana. This Arka Adya and Archana are recently released varieties from Indian Institute of Horticultural Research, Bangalore. Then coming to Ganeshkind Fruit Research Station, which is located at Pune. You kindly remember this one. Here they released four series: Pule Ganesh Pink, Violet, Purple, and White. These are also important one. With respect to private company, leading varieties Namdari seeds, Namdari Pink and Namdari White. These are important one. With respect to breeding methods, here in China aster we will majorly follow the hybridization technique or pedigree lines system. This pedigree method is very important in China Aster breeding. Here in the China Aster you observe, as I told, the ray florets are pistillate in nature. This disc florets, you observe this. This is the disc floret. This is the seed or fruit of fruit which will going to mature after the pollination in the Asteraceae. This is called akene, and this is the corolla tube, and this is the stamens, and this is the style portion, and this is the stigma. It contains both stigma and stamens, hence it is called hermaphrodite in nature. These are all the disc florets. Here only stigma will be present in the outer ray florets, hence it is in the pistillate in nature. You remember this one, this is important one. With respect to hybridization techniques like emasculation, bagging, then hand collection of pollen, you all well known these concepts. With respect to resistant breeding, there is no much evidence in India regarding this breeding, but however in the competitive exams they will ask the questions like important resistant cultivars like ostrich feather, ostrich and this feather, the fragrance of heart, these are all the important one. We have this stardust is also important one. We have faced the exams based on this objectives. Likewise, you remember this one. Here, this Arca Purnima, it's moderately resistant to Meridogyna incognita. This is also important part. With respect to mutation of breeding, the irradiation activity done at IHR, the if they kept the viable seeds of these varieties which are exposed for the cobalt 60, which is the gamma irradiating source. After the irradiation, it shows the inhibitory effects, means very less seed germination is observed. Now, what is the speciality of Kamini? Common is deep pink in color. Then Purnima, as it the name refers, it is white in nature, white in color. Then Shashank is resistant to root knot nematode. This is also important one. Shashank is resistant to root knot nematode. Then violet cushion, as it indicate, violet in color. This is the Kamini variety released from IHR Bangalore. Then violet cushion, then Pule Ganesh pink variety. Further, with respect to the seed rate, 2.5 to 3 kg per hectare. This is with respect to varieties. This seed rate is with respect to varieties. For hybrids, 1 to 1.2 kg is necessary. Then with respect to hybrid seed production, the field inspection is the one of the major operation to maintain the purity of the seeds, hybrid seeds. Usually the a minimum of 3 inspection is done at the hybrid seed production. Firstly at pre flowering stage, secondly during the flowering, and third will be before the harvesting of seeds. Then roguing, this is also one of the important cultural operation followed during the hybrid seed production. What do you mean by roguing? Off type plants which are off, not our target, like we are going for growing a specific hybrid or a variety like Shashank, Purnima, The only Sheshank will be retained in the field. Other varieties, other plants, other local cultivars, other species will be eliminated from the field. This is called roguing. In order to maintain the purity of the hybrid seeds, this operation is done. Then, with respect to isolation distance for the hybrid seed production, for the certified seeds, we will maintain 600 meters from the other fields of same variety, fields of other varieties. For the foundation seeds, FS will maintain 300 or 400 meters. This is for the hybridization purpose. With respect to seed standards, minimum purity level should be 98% for the certified or foundation seeds. This is the minimum standard for chain aster or any other floriculture crops. Then the minimum inert matter, this is the minimum pure seed factor. This is the maximum inert matter content in the seed should be not more than 2%. It should be always less than the 2% only. Then moisture should be 9%. This is the optimum. Then apart from that, with respect to chain aster or with respect to other crop, like you heard of tulip bud breaking virus. This transferred through aphids. This is commercially exploited. Why? Because in order to exploit the color variations in the tulip crop, these aphids are artificially induced to transfer this virus in the growing area in order to get the variation in the flower pattern. You remember this one, tulip bud virus transmitted through aphids. This is commercially exploited to create the variation in the tulip gardens. Remember this one. This is the one of the main objective type question. Then have you heard of the largest flower, Rafflesia? R-A-F-F.
Please repeat one second, sir.
Yes?
Please repeat one second.
Yeah. With respect to...
Sir, again repeat this.
Yes. The previous topic, which was tulip bud necrosis virus. This is actually a virus which will infect the tulip crop. This is transmitted through aphids. And this is commercially exploited in the potted plant or greenhouse condition. Why? In order to create the variation in the flowers. If this virus infect the flower crop, it will create the mosaic patterns on the flowers. This will be more attractive for the buyers. Hence, the growers will artificially inoculate this virus into the flower crop. How? By artificially inducing the aphids population in the field crop. They will transfer these virus into throughout the crop. Hence, this is also one of the main benefit of this tulip bud necrosis virus. Understood? Yes?
Yes, so it's beneficial for us.
Yeah, beneficial for us, not for the plant. Because it creates the variation in the flowers. Now that's why we are artificially inducing. That's it. Then among the annuals, this chain aster is the most popular after chrysanthemum and marigold. Then what is the chromosomal number of this chain aster? 2n is equal to 2x is equal to 18. Origin, don't forget, China. Then with respect to the nature of pollination, this is mainly self-pollinated crop. This is the exception in Asteraceae. You kindly remember this one. Then Jitinogamous condition is observed in chain aster. Then Arca Adya and Arca Archana. These are recently released varieties. Then one of the most constrained disease during the production is aster aloes. This is caused due to viral disease transmitted through leaf hoppers. Aster aloes. This is a viral disease transmitted through leaf hoppers. Remember this one. Aster, aloe. This is the constraint. This is the problem during the production. Then further, have you observed yellow colored chain aster? The pure yellow color is not present in the nature. Likewise, in the rose, will not find the true blue colored roses in the nature. Recently, we have created through genetic engineering techniques. Like that, you have to list out which are all the unique or like these points. You have to list out throughout the crop. You should keep a A4 sheet whenever while you are reading. If you find this yellow color is absent in chain aster, okay, you will write in the A4 sheet. Then further, while reading in rose, you will find blue color is absent in rose. You will write that so that at the final end of the day, you will get the all the list of the colors absent in the various flower crops, fruit crops, like that. Similarly, you can apply these techniques for the other points also. Then further, usually the propagation is done through seeds only because it is easy to propagate in Asteraceae family. This is mainly a 3 to 4 month crop. That's it. It's a short duration crop. If you choose the research topic in the MSc, you will complete the research work in 2 to 4 months. Further, you can write the thesis very easily. This is also the point you should remember. Then further, the propagation, what is the congenial temperature which favors the good seed germination means 21 degree Celsius. The flower shows the digenogamy. You should remember this. This is an important concept. What is the seed rate? 2.5 to 3 kg per hectare. This is the seed rate. Then with respect to spacing, 30 to 20 centimeter, 30 by 20 centimeter for the good quality flower production. Then flower corollary development is optimum during the range of 20 to 30 degree Celsius day temperature and 15 to 70 degree Celsius night temperature with the optimum relative humidity of 50 to 60 degree Celsius. Hence, these congenial environment will be observed in the Karnataka condition, then Andhra Pradesh, Tamil Nadu, Maharashtra. These are all the congenial areas. Then aster aloe is the most devastating disease caused by the, now only I told, virus and phytoplasma like organisms. You should remember this one. Transmitted through leaf hoppers. With respect to originator or ancestor of chain aster is Callistephus chinensis. One more uniqueness of this chain aster is this is the only species present in this genera. This is a monogenic flower crop. You should remember this one. This is also a very important objective type question. Monogenic flower crop. Okay, it means only one species is present in this genus. Callistephus. Then with respect to released varieties, Arka Kamini, Arka Purnima, Arka Shashank, Arka Violet Cushion, Arka Adya, Arka Archana. These are all from IHR. Then from Ganeshkind Research Station, Phule Ganesh White, Phule Ganesh Violet, Purple and Pink. These are all the four varieties. These are also very important. You remember Phule series, Phule Ganesh series will comes under chain aster flower crop. Then further, this will complete the chain aster. If you have any doubts, queries regarding this, you can free to ask now. Yes.
Sir, how pedigree method use here?
What?
pedigree method, how utilized here, sir?
For the breeding purpose.
Yes, sir.
I think you
means technique.
Yeah. With respect to breeding approach, here in the China Aster, which among the following? We have different breeding approaches like selection, hybridization, then mutational, then genetically engineered crops. Like this, we have plenty of approaches. In the hybridization also, we will come pedigree method for the hybridization purpose, which means we'll follow the, after the cross-pollination, we'll follow the pedigrees. What do you mean by pedigree? Its relatives, its brothers and sisters, its father and mother. Like that, we'll going to select which among these population, whether this father, mother, sister, brother, these line, which is the suitable, which is the prominent one, which have the good characters, which hybrid possess the good color variation, good yield patterns, which shows the resistance. Like that, we'll going to select among the pedigree. And this is also very easy technique to be followed in the asterisk, because this chain aster is a self-pollinated crop, so we'll get the pure lines very easily. Hence, here for the commercial breeding approach in India, we'll follow the mainly pedigree method. Okay.
Yes.
Then for the any points to add for the this discussion?
Sir, I have some doubt.
Yeah.
Sir, how we put yellow color, how you develop yellow color of China Aster?
Yes, presently we haven't tried in the India. Why? Because first point is China Aster is a very high volume, low value commodity. It means not that much high valued commodity like rose, carnation. This is mainly concentrated in the smaller southern parts of India, especially in Karnataka, Maharashtra, Andhra, Tamil Nadu. The research work is also very limited. Here we go for the only selection, pedigree method, like that only we will go. And farmers also only select for the local varieties for growing. So,
yes, sir.
To introduce the yellow color or the uniqueness in the China Aster, it should have some demand from the farmer side or from the buyer side or from the wholesale market or from the international market, export. It should have some demand. Then only the scientist will go for the creating the uniqueness in the China Aster, like creating the yellow flowers through genetic modification or through any other molecular approaches or by incorporating the any gene. But we are lacking that. What do you call demand from the market or from the farmer side?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Further? Any points to add? If it is the case, then we'll close this meeting. It was a good discussion today. What do you want to hear in the next class? What we can discuss in the next class?
Sir, today no bullet points.
Bullet points? Yeah, I have spelled out which are in my short note during the discussion only. There is nothing that much important topics or points in China Aster. With respect to recently released varieties and some of the unique concepts like no yellow color, monogenic, then some of the important varieties from IHR, then Pule Ganesh series, then with respect to the flower uniqueness, pistiloids and hermaphrodite condition, the self-pollinated, this is Geitonogamous condition of flower. These are all the some of the main bullet points. These are all the only questions which will appear in your competitive exams like JRF and SRF.
So, Geitonogamous flower, thorough discussion.
Yes. You mean, what do you mean by Geitonogamous flower? right? Any one of you know what do you mean by Jitinogamous condition? Jitinogamy means what?
So Gitana means the barrier.
Jitinogamy. Yes?
Achha, Jitinogamy means from one plant, means from one flower, pollen from one flower is matlab git hai, dusre flower, same plant.
Yes. This is the condition where the pollen from the one flower will falls on the another stigma of same flower. This is mainly observed in the black pepper. Have you seen the black pepper vine? It's mainly it will be in the like drooping condition. The upper portion of the flower will shed the pollens in the same inflorescence. The below or the in between middle flowers will receive the pollens. Here the pollination will occurs within the inflorescence or within the flower. This is self-pollinated crop. Hence, this is a unique condition. You see, if the pollen from one flower will fall on other flower, it will call cross-pollination. But here, the genetic makeup of the pollen will be same. The same flower pollen will shed on the same flower of the different stigma. Hence, here the pollen genetic will be same and the stigma genetic will also be same. Hence, this condition is termed as Jitinogamy. Here, the self-pollination will only occur. Got it?
Yes.
Okay. Then, anything else? Or we can close the meeting?
No, sir.
Okay. Okay, then take care. Read well. We'll discuss the another hibiscus talk. Can we discuss hibiscus or bougainvillea?
But
sir, we go for the gardens, sir, like important gardens, when it was established and like that, sir.
Regarding the landscaping, you need gardening,
yes,
related one. Okay, then yeah, you need the classes on gardening, types of gardening, history of gardening.
It's a formal informal,
okay.
That questions related, sir.
Okay, sure. Then we'll discuss on the history of gardening and the next class, tomorrow class. Okay,
thank you, sir.
Okay, sure. Bye.